Hey guys, it's Abby and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a review of my May Birchbox, and if you'd like to see what I think about the products I got, then let's get started. So this is what the Birchbox looks like. I like how colorful it is this time, and I think the little gold accent is pretty. And when we open it up, inside we got a little card that tells us all the products that we've got, and it says low effort, high impact, longer, warmer days are upon us, which means more time to enjoy those fun moments we look forward to all year, and less cause for primping. So the first product I'm going to start with is the Manna Kadar Cosmetics Glow Illuminator, and the full price of this product, well, full size price, is $29. And it says this unique formula subtly reflects light to make skin look radiant. Mix with foundation or apply it alone for an all-over glow. So I actually tried to film this video already, but the file got messed up and somehow it's corrupted. So I can't use it, so I'm doing this for the second time. And the first time I did this, I mixed it in with my foundation, and I didn't really see a difference. My foundation still looked pretty matte, and it didn't necessarily work. And then I applied this as a highlighter on top, and you couldn't really see it, because this is really subtle, and if you read right on the packaging, it says shimmer lotion. So since it was the second time, not already know those ways didn't really work and they didn't impress me, I am going to use this just all over as a shimmer moisturizer without any foundation today. I'm going to go very natural. That's what this whole Birchbox is about anyway, this one this time. So I'm just going to put about that much, and you can see it's kind of pink. It's a mauve-y color. And it's a little shimmery. So I'm just going to apply this all over. Oh, I need some more. Because I didn't put my moisturizer on. I'm just going to use this as my moisturizer and see how moisturizing it is, because I have oily skin, so I'm not going to put my regular moisturizer on and then add this on top. That'd be a little crazy. Okay, I'm going to put just a little more on my nose. All places I really want to shimmer. So right here, the forehead, Cupid's bow, put a little extra, make sure it's all rubbed in. Okay, so let's see. I do look a little glowy. As I can see, there's a bunch of light reflecting on the high points of my face. But I don't see a chunky shimmer. But I'm glad about that, because then it'll be really obvious, like, oh, you have glitter all over your face. So I'm actually happy that this is subtle, especially for a all-over, like, moisturizing highlight, because there is a tight highlighter moisturizer. And I can't remember the name, but I got it as a sample and I used it, and oh my god, it was like I was trying to do the highlighter challenge. My whole face was sparkly and had a shimmer, like metallic tint, the whole face, and it looked crazy. And I had to put a lot of foundation on that day, and then it just poked through like a glow through my matte foundation. It was crazy. So I definitely like this for this purpose. I think it works great. I'm glowy. I'm definitely glowy compared to before I put it on, and it's subtle. So I definitely do like this as the moisturizer for just a no makeup day compared to when I mixed it in before, because I didn't see any difference because this is so subtle. So just keep that in mind. If you're not into subtle, you probably wouldn't like this product. But if you are and you're into all natural makeup and sometimes no makeup and you want a little something, then you probably would like this product a lot. So next is the Nanette Lepore Eau de Parfum, and it comes in this little packet. It says her name, and you open it up and here it is. And it's a full size of this, depending on what you get, because you know there's multiple sizes. Ranges from $28 to $80. And it says, this floral fragrance from the fashion designer is an irresistibly bright scent featuring notes of bergamot, red currant, and plum. So, like I said, I've already done this video. So, I'm not gonna apply this to myself. Because I already know what it smells like, and I don't like the way it smells. But I will smell it again to describe it. Also, this container's weird. Most perfumes I get have a little spray. This is like, it's just like a pull top. I just got it all over me after I said I didn't want it, with a stick in it. Oh god, it just sprayed all over me. Okay, well, my problem with this smell is, first off, it's summer. And it says, it even describes it as a bright scent. When I smell this, it's like heavy. And it's really strong. Like, yes, it's floral, like it says, but it's like a heavy floral. This is something that makes me think of winter. Personally, it's also something I wouldn't wear. I really like light, fresh scents. And saying it's a bright scent makes me think fresh. And to me, a fresh scent is like fruity, citrusy, clean, and bright, and just fresh. And like, for me, a scent is fresh if I go, like, I sniff really hard, and it's not too much, and it's not gonna make me cough and be like, ugh. It's just like, ah, oh, that's nice. But for this, if you go, you're like, because it's so strong, and it's just heavy. It makes me think of like Grandma Chanel perfume. It's not my favorite, but if you like heavy floral, stronger scents, then you would really like this perfume. It's just not for me, personally. So I'm gonna put this back and not get any more on me, hopefully. And next we have the Ouai Wave Spray, which looks like this. This is a hair product. And it, a full size of this product is $26. And it says, to achieve effortlessly chic tasseled waves, spritz your damp or dry locks with this weightless texturizing mist sans salt, which means without salt, and created by celebrity hairstylist Jen Atkins. So, I've already used this for a couple days now, just to get an idea for it, and I don't love it, and I don't hate it either. So, I'm just gonna, the spray comes out really intense too. Okay, so I like that it doesn't have salt, because salt is very drying and it's bad for your hair. So it's nice that this is a texturizing spray that doesn't use salt like a lot do. But it also, when it gets on your skin, oh, it leaves you so sticky. Like, you just sprayed like legit hairspray all over, even though this is not in an aerosol hairspray can. And it does smell amazing. I love the smell. This is a fresh light scent to me. It's just very clean and fresh with like a little bit of floral maybe and just a hint of citrus. I like the smell a lot. But I've noticed it adds a tiny bit of volume to my hair, but it doesn't make it super texturized. Like, it does work a little bit, but it's not the product. Like, yes, this is the wonder product of this type of product. It's amazing. So I'm like on the fence about it. Like, it's not bad, but I'm sure it's just not the best for this. Like, maybe I'm not using enough, but I don't want something where I have to spray a ton where my hair is like soaking wet for it to work. So, and maybe I don't only use this in dry hair. So maybe also it works better if you start it with wet hair. I haven't tried that. If you're interested in this because you like a texturizing spray, you can. But it also doesn't make your hair feel like straw, which is good. So there are pros and cons. There's not really any cons, I would say. Because it does work. It's just not like, whoa, beach wave. So, yeah, if you like texture, a little bit of something in your hair, you might like this. But I'm just not saying it's not like, whoa, this works amazing for me. So, the next thing is the Beauty Crop Fabulous Flocking Lashes Mascara. And a full size of this is $22, and it's super cute. It's got flamingos all over it, and it's pink. And it says, this mascara's gentle, smudge-proof, clump-free formula is nourished with argan and jojoba oils to condition, separate, plump, and lengthen lashes. Now, I've already used this when I tried to film this the first time, and I do not like it. I know I don't like it. I'm just going to flat out say it. I'm going to put it on again for the purpose of this video so you can kind of see why I don't like it. But I don't like it. And I'm just going to do my top lashes. I'm not doing it everywhere. So, I do appreciate the fact that this has all those natural conditioning ingredients. So this is actually supposed to be good for your lashes. But in the long run, I don't really... I'll tell you at the end why I don't see how this is good for them anyway. So first off, when I put this on, it's very thin and watery, and it just like lightly coats the lashes with a tint. It doesn't add any length or any volume, and it's just kind of like womp. Like, usually there's like a whoa difference when I do one, and this is just like, my lashes still look crappy, but they're slightly darker. And this isn't even like really black. It's just kind of like, to me it's like gray. It's like, not giving it a lot of pigmentation. So yeah, that's as good as I can get it. And the container, it's so hard to get the wand back in for some reason. I'm afraid I'm gonna like break it. And this is what really bothered me, is when I went to take it off in the shower that night, I first used makeup removing wipes to try and remove everything from my face, and I was scrubbing my eyes and it was barely taking it off. And then when I got in the shower, I have a makeup removing face wash that I used on my eyes. Still wasn't coming off. Then I just used Dove soap and tried to scrub it off. Wasn't coming off. And I had to actually like take my fingers and like grab the lashes and peel it off. And I'm like, even if it's supposed to be nourishing, if it's so hard to take off that I'm having to like grab it and peel it off with my fingers and I'm yanking on my lashes, that can't be good for my eye, and I'm gonna like pull out tons of my lashes. So I'm like, waterproof mascaras are harder to get off, but this was like impossible. So I'm just not a fan. I don't really like it. I don't really recommend it because it doesn't do a lot for the lashes. It just makes them barely seeable, and then it's impossible to take off. It's just such a hassle. So I'm sorry, Beauty Crop. I've never used your brand before, but I don't like your mascara. And that makes me so disappointed and sad because this packaging is so cute. But it's a flop for me. So, lastly in the box, we have the Wish Firming Body Cream, and a full size is $36. And it looks like this, and it says, get smoother, softer skin while diminishing the appearance of blemishes, scars, and stretch marks. This miracle worker helps skin appear toned, firmed, and perfected. So I've been using this for a couple days now, and I don't have a lot of, like, just scars from injury or blemish scars. but I have a ton of stretch marks because I like food and I get bigger. So I have them like here on my arms. Can't really see them right now though because I have a fake tan and that covers them well. I have them on my arms. I have them all up my stomach, my thighs. I've got stretch marks for sure. So I've been using this for a couple days on it, and it says to massage into a desired area for 2 to 3 minutes daily. So I've been doing this, and I haven't noticed a difference with my stretch marks. And that could be just that it hasn't been long enough. It doesn't tell you how long it takes to see results. But I'll show you what it looks like. Ooh, I can't get any out. Come on. Okay, there we go. A little squirt. Like this. And when I rub it in, it's thin. It's not really heavy, which I like. I don't like heavy lotions. And it has a very light scent. It's like sandalwoody and citrusy, and it's fresh, and I like it. I like the smell of it, and it's not like very strong, it's subtle. And when you smooth it out, it just makes your hands really soft, and it soaks quickly, and it doesn't stay sticky or anything like that, which I like. I just haven't seen a result with actual stretch marks like it said it's made for. So it is a good moisturizer. I just haven't seen any results for it fixing my stretch marks. And I haven't noticed necessarily any firming. So to me, it's just like a normal moisturizer. But I could, like I said, just not be using it long enough. But I don't, I'm almost out, so I don't know if I have enough to see how long it takes to see a result if I see a result. So, and it is $36 for a full size. So if I'm not really seeing much of a difference, I feel like that's a lot for a bottle of moisturizer when you could go to Bath & Body Works and there's all these wonderful scents to choose from, and you can get a bottle for, I think it's around like $12, somewhere in that range, like half the price of this. So for me, yeah, it's cool and I tried it, but I probably wouldn't buy it again just because that's a lot of money for something I'm not even seeing it do the wonders it says it'll do. It's just like lotion. So that's all I got in the Birchbox. But I did get a free, like, full-size little gift with it. And it's the Pixie by Petra Multi Balm in the shade Wild Rose. And I figured, why not try that out when we're here? So I already know I really like this from trying it when I tried to film this before. So I take it off and it looks like this. It doesn't really have a smell. It kind of smells like the way unscented lipstick smells, which I'm not bothered by. And I was scared at first because this color is dark. But it's alright. So I'm just going to swirl. Well, actually no. So I'm going to use it as blush and as lipstick to show you how you can use it for multiple things. So I'm just going to dot this on. Like so. I'm just going to use my fingers and pat it in. And it's really pretty. Like, it's not as dark. It's sheer than in the thing, which I'm glad about, but just pat it out, and as you can see, this side I have nothing, and on this side, there's a subtle, like, pinky nude tint, and I think it's a really pretty natural blush. So I'm just going to add a little more. I kind of keep it away from the apples just because I have redness there. And it would be like crazy if I put it there. So I keep it further back, like where I would put contour and highlight. So there we go. You can see this side and then this side. So there's not a big difference. It's very subtle, but I do really like it. And it blends out so easily, which is important with creamy products. Ooh, I put a lot on. Like, I just use my fingers and pat it and we're good to go. No difficulties of blending. So that, I really appreciate that part. Also, if it looks like I put more on the side than the other, I didn't. It's just that every time I rub my face, it turns bright red. So we'll give it a minute and it'll calm down. But yeah, just put a little blush there. And I think it's a really pretty color. And I feel like this color would go with so many different skin tones because it's kind of neutral and nudey. So I feel like this would look good on pale people, medium people like me. Darker people could use it to an extent. Like, you could build up the pigmentation because this is a dark product if you build it up. I'm just using very little. And yeah, I like it. But since this is mine, I'm just gonna apply it to my lips straight. And I'm just wiping off. I have a lot of lip balm on, so I'm just wiping some off. And as you can see, when you swipe it on like this, the full pigmentation is so pretty. And that could be a really pretty blush color for a darker person. But for someone like me, lighter people, it's a really pretty lipstick shade. And I think it's really pretty, even with this no makeup look. See, now sometimes you put lip, you'll put lip color on even if you don't really have anything on your face and it like looks weird. But this, it still looks good with this, which I really like. And I feel like it really ties in with the color on the cheeks. And lastly, I'm just going to take my finger and get a little. And I'm just going to dust it on my eyelid for just a tad bit of color. Just a tad. Just to show you, there's really, you can put this anywhere you want. And as you can see, this side compared to this one, this side is like this, and this side, it looks more tight. I think it just looks more put together, and it's really pretty just to have that slight shade on the lid. So I think this is perfect for a no makeup day, but I want to put just a little something to make me look less tired, just look a little more put together. So let me put this on as eyeshadow, lips, and blush, and you're good to go. And just a little swipe of mascara. You don't need foundation or any of that. I got it on my nose. There we go. But there we go. And that's how this looks. So thanks so much for watching this review. I hope you liked it. I hope it helps you decide if you want any of these products, if you'd want to try Birchbox. So just had a brain moment. I hope this helps you. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe. Comment if you want to see more videos like this. I think they're fun. And comment other video ideas. I'd love to see what you guys want to see. And just thank you so much for watching, and have a great day.